Okay, so we are discussing about cross validation. Okay, so cross validation means usually there will be two types of cross validation. One is fivefold cross validation, another one is tenfold cross validation. Means here, if k value is 5, then it is called as fivefold cross validation. If k value is 10, then it is called as tenfold cross validation. So what happens here is mainly the whole data will be there, right? So whole data, what we do, so for example, this is whole data. So in that whole data is there, then what we do, fivefold means it will divide into 5 parts: part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, part 5, means 5 equal parts. It will divide into 5 equal parts. Then what it will do, so first it will keep aside first part. In first round, what it will do, first part of the data it will keep aside for validation. Remaining 4 parts it will take, and it will get the training, which means 4 parts will be used for training purpose, and 1 part which is hidden, that is used for validation purpose. Okay, that is first round. In second round, what will happen, second part will keep as hidden without showing, then remaining 4 parts will be used for training. So that way they will predict on the second part now in the second round. Then in the third iteration, what happens, third part of the data will be used for, that will be hidden for validation purpose, it will use, they will keep, and remaining 4 parts data they will use for training purpose. So like that, in the fourth part also, like fourth one will be used for validation. So like that, in the fifth round, what will happen, fifth part will be kept aside for validation, remaining 4 parts will be used for training purpose. So this way model can be ensured that, like, without getting to get the better results, this can be helpful actually, without getting any overfit and all. Okay, so usually k value will be either 5 or 10 actually. So the universal law is either 5 or 10 you can use. So normally you can use both and see whichever is giving good results, we can go ahead with that. Okay, so that is about cross validation. So any other questions, any interview questions we have, we can discuss here. So that is about cross validation. So in detail we will see again another session. This is very quick, a question and answers. So we talked about cross validation. Better you can go and read book, that ISLR, Introduction to Statistical Learning. That book, 10 chapters are there actually. Even same professors given videos also for 10 hours videos. Okay, so sometime we'll share that videos as well. So if time permits, you can read that book also. Okay, so you can read that Introduction to Statistical Learning book. That is written in R language, but that is fine. Just you can use for understanding the concepts actually, that book, ISLR, Introduction to Statistical Learning with applications in R. Okay.
Hypothesis testing.
So, okay, see, regarding hypothesis testing, what happens is, like, always hypothesis, there will be like two types of hypothesis, right? So null hypothesis and parameter hypothesis, which means what it will do is, always what they do is, we'll assume something is wrong. Okay, then we'll try to show with one value as whatever we assumed is contradicted, which means to prove that there is some dependency. Okay, so hypothesis, we'll use that mainly to prove that actually whatever we assumed is like correct, we are getting or not, for that purpose we'll use actually. Okay, so for that we have to learn about the definition actually. So about so that is null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis, two are there actually. So in null hypothesis, whatever we have assumed, okay, so we'll assume that whatever to be proved actually. Alternative is very opposite actually, opposite of null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis. So one we have proved that we have as a wrong, then it will be like other, like that. So these are very important actually for interview oriented. So if people have a look at it once, both. So what exactly difference between null hypothesis and alternate hypothesis. So in previous, in next sessions in detail, we'll discuss again these two. So keep in mind that these two are like opposite to each other, null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Yeah, any other questions?
p value.
Okay, yeah, p value, yeah. So actually the p value means it is p value basically that will show the importance, actually how much important the variable it is, it will tell. Okay, so suppose p value is more means that variable is very very important. If p value is less means that variable is less important, like that. Okay, so basically it will say importance of features, means how much important it will tell actually. So basically I have used more in R language actually, this one compared to in Python. So in R language when I was using project, right, mostly we are using p value actually. Okay, so that's what about p value. So to tell how much important each variable, p value will tell. So usually value is 0.1 and above is more important. Suppose 0.1 means 0.1, if it comes, that p value that is more important usually. So like it will come like 0.001, like that also. Okay, so more p value, it is like it is more important, like that. That is about p value. Then so let me open my notebook. And one more thing, in classification trees, right, in classification trees, okay, just 1 second. So just now we discussed about there in decision trees two types. Okay, which are the two types? One is regression tree. This one we'll see again, regression tree and classification tree. In regression tree, we understand RSS value to be reduced. How it will do prediction? Because there is a numerical type prediction, a regression, so they are using mean. Now, second one is what? Classification tree. In classification tree, what error to be reduced? Classification error to be reduced. Suppose if accuracy is a goal of your project, then tree growth is not a problem, okay? What are the two measures are there in classification tree? Means two types of measures is there. One is Gini index, second is cross entropy. So in Gini index, what happens is, so if observation is close to 0 or 1, because classification itself, it is either 0 or 1, right? So if your observation is very close to 0 or 1, the Gini index is very small. Why it is small? Means it Gini index is like a error actually. How much less error is there, that much better for us. That's why this should be small actually. Gini index should be small. So small, then it will predict if it is closer to 0 or 1, Gini index is small actually. So for that formula is there actually, sigma k is equal to 1 to k, that we will see. That is p cap into 1 minus p cap, that we will see. So next, after Gini index, second one is cross entropy. Cross entropy also, if it is 0, closer to 0, if observation is closer to 0 or 1, then it will go closer to 0, not like minimum. In Gini index, it will go to minimum if observation is closer to either 0 or 1. But in cross entropy, it will go closer to 0 instead of closer to, instead of smaller, like in Gini index, it will be smaller. But in cross entropy, it is not smaller. It will be closer to 0 if observation is very close to 0 or 1. So these are the two different measures, Gini index and cross entropy, in classification trees. Okay. Next thing is, what is the drawback of decision tree? It may come back. So decision tree drawback is variance is high. Variance is high actually. So for that reason, so decision tree, what people will do, they will go for next technique called bagging. Okay. So bagging means bootstrap aggregation. So next heading you can keep as bagging. Okay. So bagging means what they will do, instead of one decision tree they will take multiple decision trees they will take, so that an average it will give the better results actually. So what will happen? So there, so repeatedly same samples will be taken from different decision trees actually. So there is something called pruning. Pruning means unnecessary branches, unnecessary they will cut down actually, which means some variables will be not useful. So those and all they will say pruning actually. In the decision tree, prune means one branch, if you cut, one condition will be taken out, like that. So if there are so many conditions, very difficult for model to predict. very few conditions are there, that is few branches, it is better so that we can predict better actually. Okay, so that is the thing. So that's why pruning will happen, that is some branches they will cut. Okay, but in bagging that pruning not required actually, because there will be hundreds and thousands of decision trees actually that will help to improve the accuracy and all. That is the reason. So but overfit won't happen. Overfit means the results won't be good actually. So that problem won't happen because error will be settled down actually. Even though hundreds and thousands trees are increasing in bagging technique, so error will settle down. That is the reason. So that variance drawback is there in decision tree. In bagging, we don't have variance drawback. So that is the reason. So most of the times we'll be going for bagging instead of decision tree. Okay. So that is about decision trees, regression tree, classification tree. Just very quickly, bagging technique we have seen. So in the next session, we will see in detail actually. So that is the thing. Okay, so regarding the number of trees, the depth of the tree, all that. So this will be so when we are keep changing, right? So based on the results, so usually decision tree means normally it will be 100 will be sufficient actually. So normally some 100 and all will be sufficient actually. Okay, so the number of decision trees, depth will be usually 2 or 3 will be their depth. Okay, so. So there is some command actually, so you can able to find it for our algorithm, how many trees were used, how much was the depth of the tree, that we can able to find it. But usually 100 decision trees will be sufficient actually to predict better way. Okay, so in our algorithm we can check that whether it was 100 or 150 or usually up to 500 also it may go. So that we can see based on the problem actually. Usually 100 will be the good decision trees to be considered
using grid search. So
okay, so about grid search, what will happen is grid search, okay, keep heading as grid search. So here there will be like grid search is like permutation combinations it will try, like different number of decision trees, different depth, like all the parameters it will take permutation and combinations and everything it will try. If data is very very small, is okay to do grid search. But in a big organization, if many big data science team is there, if you start grid search everybody, then all the processing core time will be used for grid search. So it is not recommended. So usually what we do when we are going for night, right, night job, we can run and go. So by the next day results will be ready like that. Otherwise usually if everybody is working peak time, we should not use grid search actually. So because permutation combinations it will use. Okay, so that is the reason. That is about grid search. Yes, Krishna, go ahead.
Yeah, suppose in random forest, I train like 100 decision trees. So once my model is good, it's ready to predict.
Okay.
So how when you deploy, how it will be like? We have 100 decision trees, all parameters we have, how it works?
Okay, see how it works. First of all, there is no difference between normal development and production, right? There is no difference between production and normal data, this thing. Okay, so how it works means, see, we have to understand how decision tree works, how bagging boosting works, that we have to understand. Okay, so what it will happen, suppose bagging technique if you take like random forest like that. So each decision tree will give one value, right? As just before I explained, regression, how it works, each tree will give one value. So that what we do, all the trees, whatever average value, it will be taken. If it is regression, means average value will be taken. In the classification problem, So there is no difference, Krishna. So whether production or it is normal development, it is no difference how it works. Only you can see how results are coming. That is what I think your point is. How we know how whether results are good or not in production, right? That is what are you asking? Or you can reframe your question.
Suppose I train 100 decision trees.
Okay.
So each tree have different parameters, right? Once you train.
Okay. Okay.
So these parameters will carry, I mean, it hold each descent with those parameters, right? When you predict,
yes,
example, so it will use those parameters, right?
Correct. Yeah.
That's my point.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Correct. Only see each descent tree. See one descent tree may be using depth 2 or 3. Okay. So number of branches will be different. So like that will be there. Each decision tree will have its own parameters because each decision tree will be considered as a different algorithm, right? So one decision tree will predict one value. Second decision tree will predict another value. Third decision tree like that. Okay. So then based on whether it is a regression or a classification, what we are doing, we are taking average if it is a regression problem. If it is classification means it is called majority voting. Suppose in 100, 80 will predict one means one will be taken. 20 will predict 0 means then in this case majority is 1. So with majority our random forest will predict. So whichever majorly predicted one, most decision trees told 1 means will random forest will tell 1 is the output. Suppose more decision trees will tell 0 is the outcome, then random forest also will tell 0 is the 1 because it will go majority voting in terms of classification. If it is regression, average value it will take and it will predict in case of random forest. Yeah, that is the thing.
In classification, you have two voting, right? Hard and soft. I read in some article.
Okay. Okay.
Hard means like predict probability method, right?
Mm-hmm.
0. So how much the probability for that class? If you predict 0.8 means that is class 1, suppose.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Class one. Okay.
If you keep soft, they take average of the probabilities and then it will decide which class. When you keep hard voting means it will mm-hmm. take 1001, take max votes and it gives the result.
Okay. So if it is hard means in terms of hard, it is it will take like majority voting. If it
yeah,
is
majority voting.
So it will take something soft like means, average. Huh? Okay.
Soft means it get the all probabilities like 0.6, 0.9, all probabilities, then it will by number of decision trees.
Okay. Yeah, that is good. So usually whatever we are doing as per standard, that is the thing. So classification tree will take approach of majority voting. So whichever is majority told actually. So good to know that, like good, you told soft and hard. Okay, in detail I'll see once, but usually this good is the thing. Run. Yeah, okay. Okay, that is good. Thanks.
You book this one.
Pardon, I can't hear.